Welcome back to Go Incognito, viewers, and get ready for a lesson about your Media Access Control address, or MAC address. If you enjoy Go Incognito and our thorough approach to security, privacy, and anonymity, but you want some more individualized attention and help, we just publicly opened consulting. This is a premium and limited service that can only accommodate a few people. So if you're interested in getting that individual support, we're here to help you out and get you taken care of to fast forward your privacy today. Enjoy this next lesson. A MAC address is a device's unique hardware address. Almost every device uses one, and the name has nothing to do with the Macintosh, even though Macs do also have MAC addresses. So what's the problem with these, and why should you be concerned? Let's find out. If you were to gain access to a network, let's say a free cafe's Wi-Fi, you would be able to see the MAC address of every device connected to the network. MAC addresses are tied to your hardware, meaning every time you connect to a network, it logs what device is accessing it, as well as the time and the type of bandwidth going through the network from that device. If you go to the same coffee shop throughout the week, it recognizes it's the same device. They can even cross-match security footage and MAC addresses to figure out exactly who is doing what on what network. And this gets even more extensive with companies like Starbucks, who might say this information across all of their stores. Since every MAC address is unique and tied to only your device, it turns into a tool that can be used to track you. When you walk around, your smartphone scans for nearby Wi-Fi networks to connect to, and in doing so, broadcasts its MAC address. A company named Renew London used trash bins in the city of London to track people's movements around the city based on their MAC addresses, which can then be tied to a person's identity. So, what can we do? The easiest way to thwart MAC address tracking is by changing our MAC address so no one is able to tie traffic to a specific device. On Windows, these are the instructions for today, they might change. Check out the changelog to keep up with the changes for Go Incognito. Keep in mind that your Ethernet adapter most likely will use a separate MAC address from your Wi-Fi interface, so change both. You can also use tools like Technetium, but it's not fully required. Try to do this as often as possible, or set your system up to use a new MAC address every time your computer boots up. On Mac OS, there's this great guide showing how to change your MAC address, and you can have it automatically run when your computer boots up, since any changes to your MAC address go away after a reboot. Linux has a similar process to Mac OS. I'll leave a guide for it as well. It will also go away after a reboot, but you can make it permanent by modifying some configuration files. On to mobile devices. For Android, there are a couple guides you can use to help you, and there does seem to be built-in features for newer versions of Android. For iOS, iOS 14 introduces MAC address randomization, so just enable it per network. The workaround, if you're not running iOS 14, is you tether internet traffic through your computer with a spoofed MAC address. So that summarizes MAC addresses and how to change them in order to continually make it look like you're connecting with a different device. Try to do this as often as possible to prevent people from tracking where you go and what you're doing on a network by simply logging your MAC address. To take this a step further, you can just disable Wi-Fi and other radios, and that will be your best form of protection. We'll cover all this later on. The very next lesson will be on a similar topic, networking. More specifically, how to properly secure your network. I'll see you then.